Hello friends, today I am going to say a few words about correspondence analysis using the software SPSS. So how to define correspondence analysis? We can define in this way. Correspondence analysis is a statistical technique to investigate the relationship between two nominal variables or categorical variables, especially graphically. Okay, or it is also known as through perceptual mapping in a multidimensional or for simplicity in a two-dimensional space. In another way, we can say that correspondence analysis is a geometric approach to multivariate descriptive data analysis, and it is developed by Jean-Paul Benjicre in 1960s. Hence, the correspondence analysis deals with the categorical data, and this approach converts the data into distance for creating perceptual map. Correspondence analysis is a dimension reduction technique similar to factor analysis, but it tries to relate the two nominal variables through their frequencies or counts. Here we require to develop a contingency table, which is also known as cross table, bivariate table, correspondence table, etc. While factor analysis deals with linear relationship, correspondence analysis captures non-linearity between the variables represented in contingency tables. Correspondence analysis, we can say in this way, that explanatory factor analysis plus multidimensional scaling with nominal scale variable. Suppose you want to purchase scooty, okay? So you are just searching the YouTube videos of various companies scooty and their attributes, okay? On the basis of this, you want to take some customers, performance, okay, customers choice or preference, okay, and then you decide which company's scooty you can purchase, okay. So this is the Yamaha scooty, the N Max or T Max or X Max now coming. Similarly, Suzuki is Bergman, okay, and this is Hero, this is Honda, ADB Honda, the new model is coming. So you are not ready to decide, you know, which one you would like to purchase, or that is why you want to take the preference. Okay, now in this case we are taking four companies, Hero, Yamaha, Honda and Suzuki, and the attributes we have considered that premier look, because look is one of the important factor for purchasing this scooty or any kind of things, okay. And another thing is good mileage. Regarding scooty, mileage is also important thing, because nowadays petrol prices exceeds 100 rupees per liter in India. After sale service is also good, okay. Parts are whether easily available or not, that is also important part. Similarly, whether the product, the quality of the product is quality product or not, and good resale value. So we have considered these six attributes, okay, and we have considered four companies. Now the questionnaire we have prepared like this. This is the company, first column company, and in first row the attributes, okay, premier look, good mileage or not, the easy availability of parts. The answer will be yes no response, okay, by the respondent. Yes means the respondent is giving yes positive response on premier look on Hero. Similarly, premier look on Yamaha, another respondent may give this type of response. Now coming to after getting the response, okay, how it looks in Excel file. In the Excel file you can write in this way. So company, and this is attribute, and since the software cannot able to understand these words company, so we have to convert in numerical term, 1 2 3 4, okay, numerical term. There is no hard and fast rule that you have to put 1 against Hero or 2 against Yamaha, any number, okay, maybe 1, any number, maybe 2, like this. Similarly, attributes, there is no hard and fast rule to provide 1 2 3 4 for attribute, okay, and just we have given 1 for premier look, 2 for mileage, like this, and after sale service 3. So in this way, and this frequency is nothing but how many persons give yes response corresponding to premier look of hero. How many persons give yes response or positive response towards hero for good mileage? So this is the count or frequency. Okay. And another way to collect information, you know, with the help of internet, Google form. You go to Google and write Google form. Okay, then click Google form, Google form, or click here also. You can put here also. Okay, Google form. Now let's see what type of forms are coming. Google form, personal. Okay, click Google forms, personal. Now it looks like this. Blank, start a new form. Okay, just I have created, I'm showing because it will take time if I create. Okay, Google form for questionnaire. Okay, how it looks. You can also prepare the Google form in this way. If you want to take a little bit information, basic information regarding the respondents, you can take the gender, the age, okay, occupation, in this way, education. Now coming to our main questions, hero. Okay, premier look, yes or no, good mileage, yes or no. In this way you can collect and then you send it to various emails. Okay, so after getting response, you download this response and you will get the data with respect to your online. Okay, so after getting the data, what you have to do, you have to prepare a table. That this is known as correspondence table or cross table, cross tabulation. Okay, here attributes in the one column and company in the row wise, attributes in the column wise. You can also write attributes here and company here, and write the number of positive responses here. Okay, so this is the known as correspondence table or cross table or bivariate table, like this. It is already explained. Now we have to export the information to our SPSS software. Okay, after exporting this, how it looks. Suppose it will look like this. Okay, so this is the company string variable, and this is numerical value. So I cannot able to give company full form because identical, it will be identical name, it will not work, it does not work, or the software does not support. That is why company, just skipping Y, numeric value. You have to give here the numeric value in this way. 1 for Hero, 2 for Yamaha, 3 for Honda, 4 for Suzuki. Okay, click OK. Similarly, for attribute also, I have to give these values in this way. Okay, numerical value. Okay, okay. So this is data view. It looks data view. Now, what you have to do? First task is to go to data. Okay, weight cases, and give weight cases by frequency variable. So give here the frequency variable. If it is here, suppose here, so you have to give frequency here. Okay, and then okay. Okay, now you have to do in this way. You have to go analyze dimension reduction, correspondence analysis, and give row. You know, suppose this is company, you have given company as row, and column the attributes. Okay, you have to define the range. Since four companies, we have to give in range 1 to 4. Okay, similarly attributes, 6 attributes are there. Give minimum value, maximum value, update. Okay, in this way. Then model, click chi-square. Distance measure is measured through chi-square, and the normalization method is symmetrical. This is by default. Okay, continue. Statistics, correspondence table, overview of row points, overview of column points. Continue. And plot, by plot, row points, column points. Okay, and display all dimensions in the solution. Continue, and then we can click OK. Okay, click OK, and you will get the result. Though it is already done, that is why it is just a result. This is the result. This result gives first the correspondence table that we have already calculated by manually. Okay, on the basis of the data, premier look, hero 40, good mileage 120. So in this way, good after sales service 120. So this is the correspondence table or cross table. Okay, here active margin means row sum. Okay, this active margin means column sum, column sum. Okay, that means out of 490 people, you know, they are interested in hero, and out of these 490, 40 people